I like my food local. Gonna know where my cows have been. I like my food.
Hi, my name is Hans Peter Meyer, and today I am talking to Karen Foraker. Karen is one of the owners of Snapdragon Dairy, but mostly what we're going to be talking about is Legato Gelato. So what is Legato Gelato?
Legato Gelato is the only goat milk gelato you'll find on Vancouver Island. We make it from our own goats, from our own dairy. My business partner Jackie Ayton and I started this a year ago. And what we're trying to do is make the best gelato out of the best food that we can find so that it just tastes great.
So we're going to get to the gelato, but first I want to know how you got to, what are you doing in Fanny Bay raising goats?
Well, I started in Victoria, moved to Powell River, started a little farm, figured out...
Did you know anything about farming?
No, nothing. Gardening, yes, farming, no. But moved back to Vancouver Island because it was home. And had goats ever since because they're fun. Kind of like a cross between a dog and a cat. They're entertaining, they're affectionate, and you can get milk out of them.
Now your farm is not very big. How many acres have you got?
We're on 1.6 acres, mm-hmm. which for what we're doing is actually plenty big enough. So.
Really?
Yeah. Well, we've got lots of room. There's the power lines and stuff. We can take the goats for walks when.
Right.
So there's lots of room for them to play too when we go out.
Okay. So 19 years ago, you had this idea of having a farm. You got into goats. You've got 1.6 acres. You've got 40 goats right now, is that
we
right?
Have about 40 goats right, yeah. But about half of those are yearlings or babies.
Right.
So the yearlings are bred this year. They'll be kidding in the spring. And then we'll have probably 60 goats for a little while anyway.
Right, so you were talking about that. So you were raising these goats. You figured they needed to pay for themselves.
Yeah.
You were selling some or all of your milk to a goat dairy.
We started selling our milk to Salt Spring Island Cheese because the owner of Salt Spring Island Cheese, David Wood, came to Vancouver Island specifically looking for goat milk for his cheese.
Mm-hmm.
So we went about and got ourselves established as a licensed dairy so that we could produce milk and then ship it to him to process.
Right. So why the shift to making your own gelato?
Well, after a couple of years, his business plan changed and we felt that we needed to have more sources that we could use our milk for.
Mm-hmm.
Because having only one place to sell it is just not financially sound.
Mm-hmm.
So we went looking for ideas and we came up with gelato because there's a lot of really good cheesemakers around already.
Mm-hmm.
And that's a whole nother level of skill and licensing.
Right.
So
what were the steps to getting to making gelato?
First off, we had to come up with some recipes to see if we could actually make this work.
Right.
And then we had to have a licensed,
right.
Dairy processing plant, which meant the big pasteurizer to cook the milk in.
Right.
Because in this country, you have to have your milk pasteurized. So fortunately for us, Tree Island Yogurt was just getting established.
Mm-hmm.
And they have a lovely pasteurizer, and they were willing to pasteurize our milk at their plant.
Mm-hmm.
So we went, we created an agreement with them to process our milk and make our gelato base, which is basically a runny custard base. And it all has to get pasteurized, eggs and everything. So it all goes in the pasteurizer together.
Now, what I also found interesting is that you use Lush Valley's facilities as mm-hmm. part of the process as well. So if you don't know, Lush Valley is among other things, has a commercial kitchen does amazing food security work here in the Comox Valley. So tell me about this.
They do. Yes, and they're expanding too with what they have available for storage and processing. But in order to process food for commercial sale, you have to process it in a licensed commercial kitchen, which means the health inspectors check it out regularly.
Right.
You can't just do it in your kitchen and then accidentally mix the peanut butter in because you used the wrong knife, you know.
Right.
So we go to Lush Valley to make up the mix for the base, which is the eggs and the cornstarch and all that stuff. So it all gets mixed up there and put in buckets, and that all gets taken to the plant and poured into the pasteurizer at the same time.
Mm-hmm.
But then we go back and we mix up our what we call coulee, which is the fruit. and the sugar and lemon juice and all that stuff, because it has to get cooked down as well.
Right.
So that all happens again at Lush Valley.
Right.
And then again, it goes into buckets and gets frozen until being used.
And so, then you make the gelato. Now, what's the difference between gelato and ice cream?
The biggest difference is the fact that gelato only has 10 to 20% air whipped into it. It makes it dense and rich. Mm-hmm. Ice cream can have anywhere from 100 to 200% air whipped in. So the really cheap ice cream that's like fluff is fluff. So.
So am I not getting like a bunch more calories when I eat gelato?
You're not, because you're just getting it in a smaller container.
Mm-hmm.
And with our gelato, because it's whole milk as opposed to cow cream, it's half the fat.
Right.
And because we're not using fillers and preservatives and powdered milk and stuff, you're just getting the straight 3.5% fat content, or 3.25% fat content of the goat milk.
Wow.
Plus all the sugar, of course. We're not talking a low calorie treat here, but we are talking a treat. I mean, it doesn't take much gelato to make you feel like you've had something to eat.
Okay, so what flavors do you make year round?
Year round, blackberry, raspberry, strawberry, cranberry, chocolate, lemon, and we're experimenting with caramel and cinnamon, which is a traditional Mexican recipe. We are working on quince for this fall, if the quince crop comes in at our friend's house. And we've been playing around with a peach amaretto.
Oh, okay.
So, yes.
So where can I get this?
Well, you can get it here at
Red
Tree.
Right.
We are also locally in Courtney up at Seeds in Cumberland, at an edible island.
Right.
And we're now in Discovery Foods at Oyster River, and we'll be in their second store shortly. We're down at the General Grocery Store in Old Town in Duncan.
Mm-hmm.
Cabra Bay at the Peppers at Cabra Bay, and at Lifestyle Market on downtown Victoria.
Great. I mean, and this is your first year, so I imagine
this is the first year, yeah.
So I imagine we're going to find you in other places within a year.
Yeah.
But this is a series about the Comox Valley Farmers Market.
Yes.
And I remember when you launched last year.
Yeah.
Tell me about your relationship to the market and what role it plays in what you're doing here.
Well, the market is where we were actually able to start last January. That was the first place we sold any gelato.
Mm-hmm.
And it's been a great marketing venue for us, because it's where people can come and actually taste the gelato before they buy it. Because it's made out of goat milk and it's made locally and we don't do huge batches, it is more expensive than traditional ice cream. And people generally want to know it's good
right.
before they pay for it.
Right.
So for the farmers market, we can hand out samples. It's also a great place to meet people. It's a great place people give us suggestions of stores they'd like to see it in.
Mm-hmm.
It's close to them. There's a couple more up in Campbell River I'm going to be talking to this year. And down island, we're slowly expanding. So it's also a wonderful place to meet other farmers, other people with the same attitudes towards food, people who are looking for good quality food, local food, good tasting food.
Mm-hmm.
So it's been wonderful connecting with people that way and meeting the other farmers like Barb and Brian Odegaard from Ironwood Farm. That's why our strawberry is named after them. That's where we're getting all our strawberries
right.
from.
Right.
So.
Okay.
Yeah.
Okay. Now, so this is, we're just moving into January 2014. Mm-hmm. It's your anniversary month. You've talked about some of the flavors that are coming up. What can we, as consumers of your gelato, what can we look forward to in the year coming up? Or what are you excited about?
We're excited about doing the gourmet picnic again in the fall. And there's going to be a big motorcycle rally up in Cumberland this spring. We've been invited to go up there to vend.
Mm-hmm.
And we're looking at attending some of the local fairs on the island. And we're looking into vending at those as well. So we're just exploring all our options. And we're looking also at getting into quite a few more stores.
Okay.
So.
Okay. Well, thank you very much.
Well, thank you.
And congratulations on your anniversary.
Oh, lovely. Thank you.
And best of the year to you. And thank you for watching this. I hope you get a chance to either come down to the market and taste some of this stuff or get out to one of the local shops that carries it. This at Red Tree Specialty Coffee here, they do have amazing coffee. And
yes, they do.
If you're going for a walk in the airpark, you could pick up some gelato too.
Yeah.
Okay. Thanks a lot.
Thanks so much.
where my cows have been. I like my food local. Wanna know my fish swam up a stream. I like my food local. Wanna know that my hens can roam. I like my food to come from my home.